Hello and welcome. Thank you for letting us share a part of your day. And you know what? I'm just sitting here and I'm already kind of getting the Christmas spirit because I have somebody here that she's telling me things I'm just amazed to find out. Colleen Mooney is here. Mooney.
Yes.
And she's here on behalf of Operation Christmas Child. And you think, well, you know, it's kind of early to think about Christmas. But this is amazing. This is a worldwide organization.
It's a worldwide ministry.
And a ministry, and Franklin Graham started this, didn't he?
He did. 25 years ago, last year, we celebrated our 25th anniversary, and God has just really blessed this ministry and get us able to put shoeboxes in over 157 different countries.
157 countries.
Yes. And we've done 160 million shoeboxes over this time. And it's just been a blessing. Last year, in 2018, we collected over 10 million shoeboxes worldwide.
But somebody has to be sure that what is in those shoeboxes is appropriate.
Yes.
That it isn't something dangerous or, you know.
That's true, because there are some things that because of the customs laws that we can't allow in a shoebox.
Well, and something that a child might get that would be harmful.
And something inappropriate, like war items. You know, we try to get away from guns and those kind of war items.
And you don't want medicines or food or candy bars or anything like that.
No food, no candy, no toothpaste. So, because some of those things, they have trouble getting them into the country. So, and they can't read English. They don't know. It smells really good. So it could be eaten instead of used for its intended purpose. So we do provide a list on our website. We have materials that we give out that have a list of things that are suggested. And in fact, I brought a shoebox with me.
Well, I want to hear all about this, Colleen. But this goes on all year long.
Yes. So in fact, some people, when Christmas was over, they started going to the different shops and getting things that were on sale to start filling their boxes for next year. In fact, we do have a list of items that schedule for January and February so that they can
collect
different items. All right,
if you have a shoebox and you get the things and you put it in there, are there certain places designated that you can take these shoeboxes and drop them off, or are all the churches involved, or how do you do this?
Well, it's not just churches. It's churches and it's school and it's community groups.
Okay.
And on our website, there's a list of the drop-off location that's closest to them. There are several in the upstate.
Okay.
And so even if you're listening and you're out of, say, we're in the Greenville and Pickens area, but there's also a Crossroads team that works in Spartanburg County and Lawrence County.
Okay.
So, but there's a drop-off location very close to you. So you can take them there. You can also mail them to a processing center. So there's many ways. In fact, we had a story. There was one lady that was, when she heard early on that Franklin Graham needed boxes for God, is what she said. She lived in Appalachia, and she went around to her community, which was not a rich community. And she said, you know, we need these boxes for God to get this for these children. And she drove to Charlotte on Thanksgiving Day, because that was the only day she could do it, with a truck load of boxes.
Oh.
So that they could be distributed. Now, that was early on. She was a real faithful supporter of Operation Christmas Child early. So lots of wonderful stories.
Colleen, do any of these things are they ever distributed in the United States? Because we have a lot of people in Appalachia and places in our country that could use help as well.
Well, they do. And but this is an international ministry.
All right.
Because this takes the gospel into areas where nobody's been.
Really?
And these are the materials that are produced and given out and that go with the boxes are in their language. And
that's
so
amazing.
It's, you know, when you consider you're covering so many different countries and each one of them have a different language. And we give, with each box, we give a booklet. It's called The Greatest Gift. And that is a booklet about Jesus because they've never heard about Jesus in their area. So they get a booklet about Jesus in their own language. It's something tangible that they can take home and read and share with their parents. So these boxes are not just for a single child. These boxes go into a community, and it's a community-wide effort. And many churches have been started from just one distribution of shoeboxes.
Now, some churches in our area are involved in this.
Yes, many churches. In fact, last year in the Carolinas area, North Carolina and South Carolina, we collected over 800,000 shoeboxes. And next year their goal is 910,000 shoeboxes. So that's a lot of shoeboxes just for North and South Carolina.
And these are all taken and distributed worldwide then.
Yes, yes they are. And there are other countries that are involved also. So the United States, they had over 8 million collected in the United States.
Mm. Could you show me what you brought these shoeboxes? Okay. What do you put in there? Give us an example.
Well, the first thing about a shoebox.
This is a typical shoebox.
It is. But again, you don't need to have the fancy shoebox.
You can use
your own. You can use your own shoebox that you have in your closet right now.
Okay.
But we collect for either a boy or a girl. So you would choose the age. And this is for a girl, and I chose 10 to 14 years old for this girl to receive this shoebox. And inside, there's just simple gifts. They don't have to be fancy gifts. So I'll talk about that later. A little stuffed toy. Little girls like headbands. A comb and brush. Some socks. Crayons, because who doesn't like crayons? And school supplies are so important because in some of these countries, the children can't go to school if they don't have any school supplies. So it's very important to include school supplies. I got all of these for $1.
What is that?
These are little hair bands that they put their ponytails in. And see, you could use this many and do 10 shoeboxes with those. And give each one all of the colors.
Okay.
Some scissors. This is a pencil case. So I put some pencils and erasers. Another interesting story is they will use their paper for school and write in pencil. And when they're finished with it, they'll erase the whole page and use that paper again. So when you're giving them an eraser, give them a generous eraser, one that's going to last a long time and maybe more than one. And let's see what else we've got. Pencil sharpener, because they need to sharpen their pencils. And it's good to have one that catches the shavings so that they don't become trash.
Okay.
Some hair clips. And then again, this could be for two or three different boxes. A water bottle. And we have found out that they really like these water bottles. And this allows them to be able to stay hydrated during the day. And another thing is to put stuff inside the water bottle so you have more room. A toothbrush. And when you give a toothbrush, give it with a holder. Because some of their things where they have to keep it might not be as sanitary as it could be for a toothbrush. And we've had stories, Peggy, of children that were so excited to get a toothbrush because they had to share their toothbrush with the whole family. Or in some orphanages with 24 other girls. So that's a very important gift. Now, we don't give the toothpaste, but again, the toothbrush is all you need clean your teeth. Sunglasses, and I packed these up so they wouldn't get all scratched up, because children love sunglasses.
Oh, no.
And when you go to our website, you can see so many videos of distributions.
And see, none of these things, nothing you've put out on the table is expensive.
No, it's not expensive. These little towels that you can drop in water and they expand. And you know,
and you're not supposed to put food.
No food.
No candy bars.
No nuts, no seeds, no. And we do also give a list on our website of things that you shouldn't send, because you might innocently send something thinking it would be good. Like there's a difference. You can send lipstick and lip balm, but not lip gloss, because the gloss is a liquid. And then some paper. You can put in a full-size notebook, or you can put in just some sheets of ruled paper and roll it up with some pencils, so it doesn't even have to be spiral bound, but this is very handy for them to use. And it fits neatly inside your box. Hygiene items. A washcloth, or one of those little poofy shower things. And also some soap.
A bar of soap, and you put it in a little plastic container.
For two reasons. One is it removes the packaging. For another, it gives them a place to put the soap when they've finished using it. They can reuse this, and they do reuse their items. And also, it just keeps the smell a little bit down a little bit, but they can reuse that. And I wanted to tell you how important it is to take the packaging. All these items came with some packaging. This is what the packaging was that was in all these items. And they don't have daily trash pickup or weekly trash pickup like we do in a lot of different areas. And you don't know where the shoebox is going, so just leave the trash. And that also makes more room in the shoebox, so you can put more things in there.
That's amazing. And you had all these things in this one little box.
In that one little box. Can you imagine being a child and getting that? And you've maybe never gotten a gift in your entire life.
And see, like,
all these things
the
are
little
in there.
Socks. And these it doesn't make a heavy.
Right. And the little flip-flops. In fact, we've had stories where children have, you know, you buy something, you go, well, I don't know what size to get because I don't know what size the child is going to, you know, who's going to get it. And the child ends up getting a shoebox with shoes that are just the right size. It's amazing what God does. God knows where these boxes are going.
Mm. And this has been going on, you're celebrating 25 years?
We did. Last year was our 25th anniversary, so.
And it's called Operation Christmas Child.
Yes.
We're going to go to a quick break, and we'll come back, and we have more information for you. So stay with us.